الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه، قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته. اللهم أحينا على سنته وأمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. أما بعد، we are continuing to see how much the Quran serves our reality and our planning and our understanding and our choices and our future, because without the Quran we're blind. That's a simple message here. Without the Quran we're blind. Blind means we don't know what's going on, we don't understand, we're always in confusion, we always have to come up with each one his own opinion, right, in response to anything, when in reality the Quran told us what was going to happen and how it is going to happen and what you should do in response to what happens. So let us see, because the Quran is very powerful. The Quran, because it comes from Allah, it has some of the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the power of guidance, the power of handing us the control over our own fate, our own will, our own choices, our own circumstances. We can change everything if we want, but we have to put the effort. So this is the brief message from this series, but I will take you today for an application for the current situation with France, the attack on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, before that Denmark and so on and so forth. It seems that people in Europe are taking Islam and Muslims for a joke. There's a good reason for that. The good reason is Allah told us وَأَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ تُرْهِبُونَ بِهِ عَدُوَ اللَّهِ وَعَدُوَكُمْ. And we did not. Allah told us, prepare all means of power to deter wars, attacks, slander, disrespect. When we don't prepare for the power that He has given us, while we have the resources, we have the human resources, the material resources, everything is in our hand, and we don't prepare the power, then it is our fault. It is our fault. The Arabs in the Jahiliyyah, they used to say, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَذُدْ عَنْ حَوْضِهِ بِسِلَاحِهِ يُغْلَبْ يُهْزَمْ وَمَنْ لَا يَغْلِبِ النَّاسَ يُغْلَبِ. In those days, it was might is right, like today. So the Arabs used to say in their poetry that anyone who does not attack people and defeat them, he will be defeated. That was the rule. Now it is the same rule. If you are not North Korea, if you are not China, if you are not Russia, everybody will take advantage of you. Message is clear. So Allah did not hide all of this from us. And here you have it, Surah Ali Imran 186. You will most certainly be tested in your wealth and in your souls. And most certainly you will hear from those who have been given the book before you, and those pagans and disbelievers, athan kathira, harmful stuff. That is too much harm, too much slander, too much lies, too much false allegations. And the purpose is to corner you, to demoralize you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا. If you hold on to your patience, if you hold on to your righteousness and piety, This is a sign of your strong resolve. I think this ayah is clear. They will keep attacking us so long as we are an easy free target. Stand up, speak up. The more you make da'wah, the less you allow the space for anybody to attack you. Either you make followers, friends, or less enemies. But sitting on your hand, not doing any da'wah, this is what you get. So we need to take responsibility for what's going on. Enough blaming somebody else. Allah told us in the Quran that we are believers in all prophets. He says, say, O Muhammad, we believed in Allah and whatever has been sent down unto us and unto Ibrahim, Ismail, Ishaq, Yaqub, Al-Asbat, and whatever was given to Moses, Jesus, and the prophets from the Lord, la nufarriqu bayna ahadin minhum. With all the attack on Prophet Muhammad, 1.6 billion Muslims, you have seen some of them killing, but you have not seen one of them attacking Isa. And you will never see a Muslim attacking Jesus, peace be upon him. Why? Because we believe in him as much as we believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Definitely, to be clear, we don't believe that he is God. We don't believe that he is the Son of God. We believe he is a mighty prophet among the mighty prophets of God. That's what we believe. And this is what he himself told them. And I can show you the references and everything, but that's not the time for it. Here, I wanted to just remark that no single Muslim who was very angry because of the attacks on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not a single one turned to attack their prophet that they claim to be following. Even the Quran told the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he himself will be hearing a lot that will make him very sad that his people are attacking him after crowning him as the king of truth and the king of honesty. After the message, they started to slander him. He's a magician, he's a sorcerer, he is this, he is that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to calm the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Surah Al-An'am, he says, we certainly know that you're sad for what they are saying. But they are not belying you, they are just denying the truth that comes from the Lord because they are wrongdoers. الظَّالِمِينَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ يَجْحَدُونَ. And many messengers before you were belied, and they were patient in the face of their belying, and they were hurt. وَأُوذُوا. They were hurt because of what they heard. حَتَّى أَتَاهُمْ نَصْرُنَا. The Nasr will come from Allah. But because we benefit from the Nasr, Allah laid some responsibility on us, and he said, if you follow this, I will support you. So there is no free lunch. Allah will not. He has given us free lunch all the time. He created us for free. He provides for us for free. He has blessed us for free. But we have to take some responsibility. This is what the Quran is saying. Okay? So it goes on to say that there is no changer for the words of Allah. The word of Allah will come to pass. Victory is certainly around the corner. Just stretch your hand to reach out to it. But don't hold your hand and don't sit on your hand and wait for Allah to give you what you do not deserve. Why? Because victory means your honor also. Allah says, وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةِ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Dignity ultimately belongs to Allah, to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to the believers. So the Prophet did his job. Allah did what he promised to do. The rest is on us, the believers, the beneficiaries of the message and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if it is too much for you what you are hearing, and you want to give them everything they ask for, dig a tunnel or fly into the heaven and give them an ayah, give them a sign. Ayat come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't kill yourself because of what they are doing. Don't kill yourself. Muslims have been responding to the cartoons since they started by killing each other. That is not rational. That is not the way it should be. So Allah gives us samples in the Quran of what they used to say about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So in ayah number 4, Surah Al-Furqan, and those disbelievers said that this is nothing but a fabricated lie, and he was helped by others. And the Quran answers, they brought a very serious falsehood. وَقَالُوا أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ They said, these are fairy tales from the old times. اِكْتَتَبَهَا He asked some people to write it for him. And by the way, اِكْتَتَبَهَا means the recognition of the pagans of Mecca that the Prophet ﷺ did not write on his own. This is their recognition. اِكْتَتَبَهَا He asked people to write it for him. Well, if he is dictating this, or if they are authoring it and giving it to him, they should come forward to be the prophets. It's just a false allegation and patently false from its own statement. فَهِيَ تُمْلَى عَلَيْهِ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا It is being dictated to him by early day and late day time. And then Allah answers, Say, O Muhammad, this was sent down by the one who knows the secrets of heaven and earth. The Quran is full of secrets that humans could never tell what it is. Even by Arabic interpretation, there's a lot of ayat that early Arabs could not understand what it is. But they believed in the Prophet because he proved himself to be a prophet for them. They were satisfied. So they accepted what they could and what they couldn't understand. Now, if you get a small boy who doesn't understand anything, he says, how could I believe when I don't understand? We became too arrogant because Allah has given us a lot of tools of power and we want to use it against ourselves. This is the intelligence of man. And they charged and they said, and why does this messenger eat food and walk in the markets? Why didn't he get an angel with him to be a warner alongside him? As if this is something he could do. As if this is something he could do. And the Quran answers. It says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we were to send an angel, we would have caused them confusion as they are creating confusion for themselves. But they don't understand. And then it goes on to say, or else a treasure be thrown unto him from heaven, or to have a paradise that he eats from. So he needs to have a special paradise that is not sown on earth, but it grows there, for him to eat from it, to say, I am living in paradise, you're living in the earth. This is as stupid as it can get. And the wrongdoers said, you are following no one but a man who has been touched by jinn, a man who has been affected by black magic. The Quran says, look how many examples they give to you, and they only misled themselves, and they have no path to follow. So this is a sample of what the Quran cites for us as to what they were saying about and to the Prophet to make him feel demoralized, to leave the message. Nobody wants to be called insane, magician, sorcerer, liar, all of these names, nobody. But the Prophet ﷺ was comforted by Allah and he knew that he was not, so he didn't mind what they were saying. Furthermore, in Surah Al-Isra, it says, وَلَقَدْ صَرَّفْنَا لِلنَّاسِ فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ We have given an example for people from every type. فَأَبَى أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ إِلَّا كُفُورًا The majority of people refused but to deny and disbelieve. وَقَالُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حتى تفجر لنا من الأرض ينبوعا. We will not believe in you until you gush a spring from the earth up for us. You see, they are thirsty and hungry people in the desert, so they want something material, right? أو تكون لك جنة من نخيل وعنب فتفجر الأنهار خلالها تفجيرا. Or else you have a paradise with date palms and grapes, so that you would explode rivers through it all the way. أو تسقط السماء كما زعمت علينا كسفا. Or to let the heaven fall upon us on the earth. Or to bring Allah and the angels lining up. Or else to have an ornamented, golden ornamented and silver ornamented house, or to ascend up to heaven. And we will not believe your ascension until you come down with a book from heaven that we can read. Because this is junk allegations, junk requirements that is not necessary and it doesn't make sense. Allah answers it briefly, says, O Muhammad, say, Subhana Rabbi, hal kuntu illa bashara rasula. Say, O Muhammad, praise be to Allah, who am I to do this or any of this? Have I been any more than a messenger and a human being? The Quran also talks in Surah At-Tawbah about people who try to hurt the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ومنهم الذين يؤذون النبي ويقولون هو أذن. And some of them, they say, he has something wrong with his ears. He is listening to some voices. You see, psychosis, right? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قل أذن خير لكم. This udhun, this ear that you are blaming to be hearing, you know, false voices and false input, these are udhunu khayrin lakum. It is a good ear for you. It brings you what is in your interest if you are wise enough to listen. يؤمنوا بالله. He believes in Allah. ويؤمنوا للمؤمنين. He trusts the believers. ورحمة للذين آمنوا منكم. And a mercy for those who believed amongst you. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Those who try to harm the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they will end up in severe torment, painful torment. So don't be sad. The Prophet was told by Allah, don't be sad. لَا يَحْزُنْكَ قَوْلُهُمْ. Don't be sad for what they utter. What they say is false. You know it is false. It's not going to hurt you. And they will pay for it. Mind you, it didn't tell us to make them pay for it. But definitely, if we had the power, they wouldn't have dared to do it. This is the point. تُرْهِبُونَ بِهِ عَدُوَ اللَّهِ وَعَدُوَكُمْ. You deter the enemies of Allah with the power you have. Many times, America wanted to fight North Korea, but they display their power and we retract. We say, no, 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 we'll talk with them. Right? Iran today is challenging the United States. All what the United States could do is what? Because they have prepared whatever they can of power. And power pushes back against power. Weakness invites aggression. This is something we need to learn. Weakness invites aggression. When you are weak in your own family, you're not a leader as a man in the household, what happens? Your wife takes a ride over your back. Your children do the same. And I'm not saying that men should be aggressive, but they should be leaders. They should exercise the authority and the power of their position as leader in the household. This is not an Islamic concept. In Christianity and Judaism, it says very clearly, the man is the head of the household. Likewise in Islam. So we should accept these rules and live by it. When you abandon your leadership as the follower of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your enemies will take the lead and you will always be on the defensive. And from a power, no, we have no power, from a powerless position, which means your defense will be nothing. No matter what you say, it's talk. It's talk. Also, in Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. Allah and His Messenger are praying and calling for the mercy to come unto the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Then following that, Surah Al-Ahzab, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Those who are hurting the Prophet, Allah and His Prophet, they are bothering Allah and His Prophet, then Allah cursed them in this life and in the hereafter. And He has prepared for them humiliating torment. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْذُونَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بِغَيْرِ مَا اكْتَسَبُوا فَقَدْ احْتَمَلُوا بُهْتَانًا وَإِثْمًا مُبِينًا. Those who are leveling false allegations, fabricated lies against the believers, male and females, they have earned nothing but a huge sin before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the Quran requires us to support the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Quran says, إِلَّا تَنْصُرُوهُ فَقَدْ نَصَرَهُ اللَّهُ ثَانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. If you do not support him, Allah has already supported him, certainly. When he was kicked out of his own home village, hometown of Mecca, as the disbelievers forced him out, إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ, as he and his friend Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu arda, were together in the cave, إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ, as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling his friend, لَا تَحْزَنْ, grieve not. Why? إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا, Allah is with us. I want to explain this a bit. We cannot assume that Allah is with us unless we are with Allah. This is a false assumption. Allah says clearly, إِن تَنْصُرُ اللَّهَ يَنْصُرْكُمْ. If you support Allah, Allah will support you. That condition has to be met. I think this is clear. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down His calm and His peace and supported him with soldiers that you have not seen. And He made the word of the disbelievers the lowest, and the word of Allah is the highest. Mind you, the ayah doesn't say, وَجَعَلَ كَلِمَةَ اللَّهَ هِيَ الْعُلْيَا. No. Allah is making a statement separate. It says, وَكَلِمَةُ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْعُلْيَا. The word of Allah is always the highest. وَاللَّهُ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Allah is mighty. I want to stop here because of the time, but inshallah, maybe next week we'll continue. The topic is not small, but inshallah, we'll follow next week, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته ومن اتبع سنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم بفضلك أرحم الراحمين. Brothers and sisters, in the response to this current situation, unfortunately, difficult situations, wars, strifes, and chaos always let the nifaq and the munafiqeen come up. Don't be shocked that a munafiq here or there, even if it is a state that is led by munafiqeen, would support France. This is expected. We should not fool ourselves. We should not say, but they are Muslims. Muslims are known by their faith and their behavior. Their faith we cannot see, it is in the heart. But their behavior reflects if they actually believe. So we should not fool ourselves and pretend that we are shocked or disappointed that this nation or that government or that leader has sided with France or failed to rebuke what Mr. Macron has done. That said, we know that Macron is wrong. We know that the teacher was wrong. But we also know that Islam does not support that we take the law on our hands as individuals. Where there is no law to support your values, it is your failure to make the law support your values. Should I repeat this? When there is no law you can use to protect and support your deen and your value, it is your failure to get the law to do that. So don't be the law. Don't execute the law with your own hand. This creates nothing but chaos. And the response to what that student did is that people attacked two women. I don't know who's alive and who's dead among them. Okay. And this is something that we need to take notice of. We should not kill each other. Yes, we should not kill others. If others ought to be killed, there has to be a law to execute them, not my hand and your hand and anybody's anger. That is not the way it should be. In the rules of Al-Amr bil-Ma'ruf wa Nahi an al-Munkar, it says that if changing evil would bring more evil, leave the evil that is, don't bring the evil that is not. We can be patient, as the Quran tells us, and we can work to deserve the support of Allah. He promised us, and we should deserve His fulfillment of that promise. So this is a point that I wanted to make, that we understand that we are not helpless except for the lack of the power. Allah instructed us to develop, to deter anybody from even talking bad about us, let alone the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معصيتك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا اللهم اجعله الوارث منا واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا وإذا أردت بقومنا فتنة فنجنا منها مولانا غير خزايا ولا مفتونين ولا مبدلين ولا مغيرين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين أجمعين اللهم انصر عبادك الصالحين في كل مكان اللهم عليك بالظالمين والمعتدين والطغاة والجبارين اللهم إنهم لا يعجزونك اللهم أرنا فيهم آية من آيات قدرتك أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فستذكرون ما أقول لكم وأفوض أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد وأقم الصلاة